Before I go and use this machine, a couple things I want to do. I want to try to switch these controls over to cat controls. So a lot of people say there's a lever somewhere. I haven't seen anything. So I think I'm going to pull this panel off, pull this back off, trace the lines back and see if there's a valve under here where I can swap them. Because I don't think this machine has a lever. I have looked behind the seat and people are saying this over here is, but if you pull this, this is just the oil for the, it's just a dipstick. So someone thought there was a lever back beyond this air cleaner and I don't see anything. I don't see any levers or anything to switch this over without changing lines around. See anything. Now I gotta figure out when I move this one. Barely moving. So, I'm gonna change all this. Doesn't look like that fun of a job to be switching this stuff around. Everything's different sizes too, you know? Kind of issue, right?
Yep. Looks like you'll have to use it as it is.
Or switch those lines out there. We got the lines that go out of here, lines go here. So these lines right here, these two lines are boom up and boom down. And these lines need to get switched to another set. Let's see. Stick out, stick in. So stick out and in would be the top piston, which that comes down to here, which goes, wait, let's make sure I get this right. Which right here. So these two lines here, and these lines, so these two lines need to get put here, these lines need to get put there. Should have had this boom out that way. I don't know why I took it apart without doing that. It's kind of stupid of me here. Now I'm fighting with this. Let's see if I can get this one. Oh, I got that one. Okay. So let's put this one over here. Now you guys can just look this up online. You know, it shows the joysticks and just everything's labeled. I mean, that's the easiest way to get everything perfect. Cause you know, you get on a machine, it's just natural. And then somebody asks, oh, what's what? And you're like, I don't know. I'll just get on and run it. Looks pretty clean, this fluid. Look at that. Not all cloudy, no water. It's definitely full. Just wanted to check that to make sure, you know. Looks good. Alright, that's all good. You have stuff apart before you put it back together, it's always good to clean it, you know? This wire's kinda... All right, I wanna throw some LED lights on this machine. So one goes on the boom, and I think I'll put one up there on top. Which makes sense because then you could kind of see everything. Hopefully that works. Look at this. I got this nice wire. So there's two wires inside this, but this stuff is the best for running anything. It just has this nice casing on it, and this is what you want. This is what I use on my roll-off trucks, and I just buy big rolls. But this stuff is awesome even for snaking through. So, all right, let's get started on wiring these lights up. Goes up to the bottom of this. We'll run it back here. That's okay. Oh, you're right there. Oh, yes. Still don't have enough power. Hurt this wire here. Anger. All right, that looks good. All right. I wanted to do it further down, but the problem is I can't get the drill in there, so. Have to deal with this, but it's got to run right into this. All right, let's check for juice here. But I've got a brand new switch, so replace that too. All right, we got juice. That's a good thing. Power. Now we know that's our power. Hold for that wire. All
me see. Oh, cool.
So I drilled that hole bigger because I want this wire loom to be on anywhere where the wire's going through the sharp metal. That way it doesn't cut through it in the future from vibrating. Lunch them in here. I might just ground this light up top. So I might just, let's not even use this wire. Still gotta run my other wire. Put that there for right now. This power wire will go over here. Choice in the matter. This wire's just up there for a minute. All right, so everything's grounded. This light should come on. Keys on. Now it goes black. And it goes to white. this wire like this. Look at that. Keep some extra wire, you know, it don't hurt. It's just sitting in there anyway. Don't fall down there. Cut it right there. So we're gonna ground that to this. That should work out fine. Nice and tight. Okay. There we go. Like that. The switch will have to go up in this hole here. But it works. Okay. Let's see if this will work now. Just there. Off, on. And that light's still not coming on. That should be grounded. Light's on. Let's see if this is getting power even. Okay, so it's getting power. This has a bad ground. I say just ground it here. Look, this works. This is working. Oh yeah. That switch to be even here. I don't know. I went ahead and put wire loom on everything. Just looks more factory, right? Up in there, I did that. All this over here, down there. Also put a piece out there. That wire loom's not that fun to do. My hands are all cramped up from doing that, but at least it's done and it looks good and all the lights work, which I guess that's the point. I bought the blue, but the can's no good, so I have to bring that back. But at least I'm just trying to touch up some of the orange paint. This is like $25 for this can at the Kubota dealer. I was just about to strap this, and I got looking at it, I said, I wonder if this will go down further so it could grab more smaller stuff.
Small truck.
Is that big?
All right, so that looks a lot better. This machine is actually working really well. It's not a new machine, but it gets the job done, and it's a heck of a lot better than picking this up by hand, that's for sure. So I got that done pretty quickly. That was a few loads of brush right there I brought down to the brush pile. So that's it. Could do definitely more stuff with this.